Now let us move to the last part of the scaffold safety. So always we have to prohibit the use of shore or lean to scaffold. Here in this figure you can see which is very dangerous, so we should not use that. When we erect or move or dismantle or when we make some alterations to the scaffold, we have to do it only under the workers has to do it only under supervision of the competent person. And in, especially in case of cold countries, the worker should not work on snow, ice covered platforms. And if we are using some loads, swinging loads, then we have to use the tag lines. And we have to protect the suspension rods from heat, acids and also corrosive substance. And the worker should not be allowed to work, especially during storms or high winds. And when the dead waste means that is when the waste materials, that is especially the construction site, sometimes it will be thrown by the workers from the top of this building, etc. So not debris should not be allowed to accumulate on the platforms where the workers stand and work. And there should always be a clearance between the scaffold and also between the power lines. That is, the clearance varies depending upon the lines, whether they are insulated or uninsulated. So less than for the insulated lines, less than 300 volts, their clearing spacing between is should be at least 3 feet. Then for 300 volts to 50,000 kilovolt, from 300 volts to 50 kilovolt, it should be at least 10 feet height. And more than 50 kilovolt, then it should be 10 feet plus 0.4 inches. So it varies based on the insulated lines and uninsulated lines. And here you can see the people who is working on the scaffold, and they are just standing on the platform of the scaffold, which are just provided with the cross bracings, etc. And here they are not, they are wearing the hard hats, but they are not wearing the harness belts. And here you can see there is no guardrails, etc. So always we have to protect the platforms with the guardrails. And here you can see in these two figures, in both the figure you can see the workers are working on the scaffold, on the platform, and they are doing some work, and they are wearing the hard hats, they are wearing the harness belts, and you can see that platform, it is guarded by the guardrails on the sides and also on the front edges, and which are safe for the workers to work. And always a competent person has to be there when an erection or dismantling of the scaffold is done, and the employers has to give personal fall arrest systems as for the protection of the employees, and they have to give some training in order to prevent the greater hazards within the site. And here you can see the guardrail system which is installed, which is provided with the rails on the sides and also on the ends, on the front ends also. And always you have to provide some cross bracings. It is mainly provided to provide strength or support to the scaffold. And when you provide this cross bracing, may be used in place of the top rail or mid rail, we can use, but when the cross points, especially when the crossing points of the places is between 38 inch and 48 inch above the work platform, that is for the top rail, and we can use the cross bracings. That is when the cross points of the places is between 20 inch to 30 inch above the work platform, that is for the mid. And here in these two figures, you can see in the first figure there is a tank type structure, and surrounding that structure, in order to provide an access, there are stairs, and also surrounding the stairs, there is access is through the stairs, and surrounding the structure, you can see a scaffold is constructed with planks, and on this on the boundary, on the outer edge of the this building, you can see rails also, handrails are also provided, that is known as the guardrails, in order to protect the worker who is working on this platform. So access is provided and also scaffold is provided with the guardrails. And the second figure here, you can see a person standing on a wooden plank, and without any, the plank is not supported firmly with any poles, etc. And here you can steer this as just an access to the plank. And a person is wearing a hat, but there is no harness belt. So it is not safe for a worker to stand like this. And hard hats are required for the employees on the scaffold. Here you can see a picture where the employees are keeping the hard hats. And there are chances for the debris to fall from sufficient height from the building. Sometimes the workers will be throwing some debris or waste. Debris means it's waste materials within the construction site, they will be throwing down. So in such cases, it can fall on the people who are working on the scaffold and also the people or the workers who are standing on the ground level. So always it is very good to provide a net like this to as shown this figure. That is for the protection of the worker. And the area below the scaffold to be of the scaffold must be barricaded. We can keep fencing that area, and employees must not be permitted to enter into the facade area. And where the tools or materials or equipment is piled higher than the top edge of the toboggan, the spanning or screening extending from the toboggan to the top of the guardrail must be installed. That is for the safety of the. And toboggan must be erected along the edge of the platform. That is to prevent the fall of the tools, materials, or equipment falling. That is from the scaffold. Should be said, the scaffold should be securely fastened to the ground also. And you can see in this figure there are aerial, there are so many machines. This type of scaffold that we are, we can name it as an aerial lift, because here you can see the vehicle. Along with this vehicle, there will be a boom which is having that much height, and at the tip of that boom you can see a basket where the people can stand and work. So there are, they are the vertical towers, and we can rotate this boom also. And this lift controlled whatever that the worker is standing and working on a basket, and the lift control should be tested each day prior to this use, and only authorized person must operate it. And belting off to the adjacent pole structure should not be permitted, especially in the case of this moving booms, and the employees must always stand firmly on the floor of the basket. And in this figure shows the aerial lift, which is extensible. It can be extended to a sufficient height, and at the tip of this boom you can see a basket where the person is standing wearing a hard hat, etc., and he has to wear the harness belts, etc. And the boom and the basket load should limit, that limit should not exceed it. And the air lifts must not be moved. When the person is working, the boom should not be rotated or should not be moved, and should be designed properly. And the extensible and articulating boom platforms, that is the body belt, must be worn by the people. And here you can see at the tip of this boom, you can see a basket where the workers are working, and they are wearing some hats which are not meeting the required standards, and they are not wearing the harness belts also. And the boom, the basket, it is safe because there are rails other surrounding the basket, but the person has to wear the harness belt. Sometimes, suppose if there is a chance by accidentally if the basket moves, that is by rotating the boom, the person has a tendency to fall from the basket, so it can cause hazard. It should be prevented by wearing the harness belt, and we should not rotate the boom also when a person is working inside the basket of the aerial lift. And this type of aerial lift is known as scissors lift, which are not actually the aerial lifts. So this scissors lift meet the definition of the scaffold also. We can say it is just like a scaffold. It look like a scissors, and here it complies the requirements of a mobile scaffold also, which is not commonly used.